There are a lot of mindfulness connectivity elements we have in our there are software elements, there are hardware elements.
So MindConnect Nano and MindConnect IoT 2040 are the hardware elements which are dedicated gateway elements for MindSphere by default, which has got a pre-configured connectivity which can connect to all SIMATIC as well as OPC UA connectivity PLCs which are available in the field. Second element is MindConnect API or libraries, by way of which you can make your gateway suitable to connect any PLC, yeah, and you can adopt that. So there are libraries, software libraries, by way of which you can have develop your own connectivity elements. Third element is MindConnect Edge Analytics. So there are a lot of data transfer which happens from the gateway to cloud. But if we have to restrict the data transfer and we don't want to cross our data ingest rate, then the edge devices are also coming, where the pre-processing of the data is available, is done at the field. Yeah, and the only important data which goes to the cloud can be sent and defined. And those are the edge connectivity elements which we can offer it to you. So there are hardware elements and there are software elements also. Another element which we have talked about is a MindConnect IoT extension, by way of which you can easily connect the MindSphere with other protocols like MQTT or Java or CC+ agents with your custom devices, and you can connect it to MindSphere. The fifth one is a MindConnect integration. If you want to connect different cloud, then the MindConnect integration plays a major role. So these are the few mind connectivity elements which we have talked about. Unfortunately, today's lockdown situation, we have to connect the automation devices, and that is what our preamble was. And we were targeting end users and the OEMs. Now there we have supplied either a SIMATIC PLCs 200 or 1200. Yeah, currently they do not have a direct mind connectivity connection, but you have to go for a SIMATIC connectivity either via IoT 2040, which has got a protocol for connecting that, and that is what we are trying to address it today, or a 1500 PLC which has got a connectivity inbuilt in it, and how to connect that. So what we feel today is we will cover these two topics, because this will ensure at least we can cater to 200 and 1500 customers, even few of the customers to 300 or 400. But I leave that detailed offering and discussion to Dhananjay, who is expert on that topic, to take up on that aspect, yeah, in detail. Further to it, we also have a standard applications which has come from SIMATIC family, and that also we will be discussing it in short post our connectivity devices are through. Yeah, and that is the demo, and the information is through. So I will hand over it to Dhananjay, and with your permission, I will start even the recording of the session also, so that the recorded session will be shared to you in due course of time, wherein if you are having any difficulty, you can refer the session again. Still, if you have a doubt, you can refer it to me or Govind or Dhananjay back, and we will try and address this topic of connectivity. One important request from our side, from Siemens, is if you have any issue, address it to me or Govind, and we will get back to you properly with the required stakeholder, so that your issue is addressed immediately. Yeah. So thank you all for participation. Let's start our session via Dhananjay. Okay, thanks.
Yeah, thank you, sir. Good morning to everyone. Today, basically, as Sandeep sir explained regarding what all the things we need to cover, basically, I'll focus on two aspects here. One is regarding connectivity point of view, and second one is the standard application which is already there on the MindSphere from FA side that can be straight away used by the customer. So I'll just share my screen. Govind, you just let me know once my screen is visible.
Yeah, your screen
anybody.
Is visible.
Okay. Yes. Yeah, thanks. Perfect. So, see, basically, everyone knows the current situation in the market, and even when we talk about the Industry 4.0 or cloud-based technology, there are different type of options are there, or different type of offerings are there from our portfolio side to fulfill customer requirement, to enhance their production, to make transparency in the plant, and so many things. So basically, if you see the today's structure, the automation period point of view, initially it was a little bit different, but nowadays the automation period pyramid has been changed. So industry till from field level to industrial automation, everything is still same. There is no much more change. Yes, there is change in the PLC side, many things, but in point of view, it has not been changed much more. So if you see, there is a layer in between cloud and industrial automation that we call as industrial edge. So depending on the customer requirement and depending on his wish, we can provide the solution what he required. So some of the solution, depending on customer, we can propose on-premises. So he is not ready to push the data outside from plant. That is our semantic edge solution is there. And second one, where today we are talking about that cloud-based solution, where the detailed analysis of the plant or factory or maybe machine could be done on the cloud level. We have different type of analytics, powerful analytics tools are there. Some of the standard applications is already there, which I have listed here. And some of the application, which is specific to the customer. So the partner like you can develop this application and give it to the customer. So that will be a even for business opportunity to you also. So that we'll see in detail. So talking about the some overview on the semantic edge, I'm not going to talk on this, but in the semantic edge also now the system is coming that we can set the premises a little bit cloud. We cannot get complete cloud functionality, but at least this will be on-premises solution. On that also we are getting a different type of application which is already there on the cloud, and apart from that we are also getting some other new application. Okay, so we'll go in detail. Basically, this is a MindSphere structure, basically. Or this is a basically structure of any cloud. To get data from your machine or line or from your devices on the cloud, basically, we need to have this three first element, that is a Mind Connect in terms of MindSphere point of view. This is nothing but the hardware element or hardware component where you need to connect your existing devices, it could be a line or machine or plant, to the MindSphere. And these are having different type of IoT gateways are there. So already we have seen in the connectivity point of slide. And second one is on MindSphere, that is nothing but the data structure of the cloud, where all the data will get stored. And on that, once the data is available from machine or line, as a raw data on the MindSphere, definitely we need to run some analytics to get truthful information in some different application depending on the customer requirement. So that we call as a Mind App. So this is just overview of MindSphere. Those who maybe are not aware, for them it will be just a little bit clear. This is already slide we have seen that. But today's situation in lockdown period, definitely we cannot order the hardware. Okay, we have a time. We are also doing some office work as well as maybe in free time. This is of the one scenario we can test it by connecting your existing devices to the MindSphere. But how to connect maybe this lockdown period. So some of the you guys having already Semantic 2014 in your premises, some of they don't have, some of them have 1500 PLC, but you cannot order the new gateways like MindConnect Nano or MindConnect 20. So instead of this one, I'll talk on the MindConnect 2040. So in the MindConnect 2040, if you have already hardware with you, then it is a quite simple to achieve that onboarding processor on the MindSphere. For that purpose, I have developed one small document basically. In this document, I have completely mentioned how to onboard this Semantic 2040 on the MindSphere side. So basically, once you get the Semantic 2040, already the forum is there on the support site, how to onboard that this thing. But still, I'll just brief you. So basically, once the hardware is available with SIMATIC 2040, what we have to do? We have to initialize the node RAID or node server of the SIMATIC 2040. Once you initialize this node RAID server, I don't know how many guys are having already knowledge on the SIMATIC 2040. If it is, if you don't know, then I'll share this document. You just go through that and you will come to know how to do it. But I'll just brief you because this is onboarding and doing other stuff. Once you start Node RAID server, we have two options. Say some of the having already SIMATIC 2040 in their premises, they can start this Node RAID server on the SIMATIC 2040 and they can start doing programming to onboard from SIMATIC 2040 data to MindSphere. And second scenario here, even you don't have the SIMATIC 2040 also, still you want to do some activity on the MindSphere side, no worry. What you can do, you can simply download this Node.js from the internet, just simply. Once you download this Node.js internet on your Windows system, okay, from the internet, you have to just install this Node.js. Once you install this Node.js, then you have to just open the command prompt of your computer and just type the command start Node RAID. Okay, likewise, okay, the command which I have mentioned here, Node RAID. Once you type this command Node RAID, then Node RAID server will start in your Windows system. Now your Windows or your laptop will become a IoT gateway, like SIMATIC 2040, MindConnect Nano or other gateways. Once this Node RAID server has been started, you have to just open the web server of your Windows Node RAID server. Likewise, by putting localhost colon 1.8.0, this is a port number, and this will be your then programming interface. So in this, you can just simply install this MindSphere node. So on the Node RAID organization site, maybe all already working on the Node RAID, they will come to know. So through Node RAID, you can simply install this MindSphere node, which is a completely free of cost available. So anybody can use it, MindSphere. Just I'll put it here, then this node. So you have to install this Node RAID in your just copy paste and paste it here and then enter it. Then Node RAID will, that particular MindConnect gateway or this library will get installed in your Windows system. And then they just simply, you know the procedure of how to onboard any devices on the MindSphere site. You have to just take the copy of that agent, that particular security file from the here, from MindSphere's portal and paste it here and your MindConnect Nano. And from that, the application is also given in this complete procedure, how to do this thing. So you have to just refer it. And then you, with the help of this procedure, you can onboard your Windows system on the MindSphere site. And then you can do the activities you want to do it, some testing, maybe Modbus TCP, OPC, or SES7 communication. To test this different type of communication protocol also, already if you have TI portal installed in your same laptop, you know our SES7 prepared PLC having a simulation software, that is a PLC Sim Advance. So with the help of PLC Sim Advance, even you, that PLC Sim Advance, with the help of this S7 node, you can connect to this MindSphere node, and then you can simulate your S7 PLC data. You can simulate Modbus TCP communication. You can simulate OPC communication also. So without using any one gateway also, this is only a temporary solution during lockdown. You can test all the functionality, which can be similar possibly into the SIMATIC 2040. So there is no much more difference. So this, you can do it. Okay, I'll share this PPT and document also with you for your maybe future development. So that is about SIMATIC 2040. And regarding say 1500 PLC, let's say if you don't want to go with this Node RAID server, but that is a quite simple language to do this all this activity. Let's say if you want to do direct connectivity with MindSphere from hardware, maybe 1500 or 1200. Just I want to highlight here, in the 1500 PLC, it is possible to onboard this your existing 1500 PLC directly on the MindSphere. But only thing you have to consider that there is no buffer facilities available in 1500 PLC. So there is no standard function which can do the buffer things. And whenever the there is again connection disconnection happen, it will synchronize data to the MindSphere. So in the logic itself, when the scenario is very, when the scenario will come, for example, 1500 PLC are connected to the MindSphere. Maybe 1 month everything was running perfectly, but after 1 month there is a say internet disconnection. So locally, then you have to log all the data which is coming from machine into the PLC, local memory. And once you get the internet connection, again, you have to synchronize all the leg data to the MindSphere again. So that procedure you have to keep in mind, how we can do it in the 1500 PLC. So if you are able to do this activity, or if you are able to do all these things in smart way, then I would recommend you can directly connect 1500 PLC with MindSphere. And if you are not able to do it, then I would recommend don't go with 1500 based connectivity then. So then directly go with Semetic 2040 as well as MindConnect 2040 or MindConnect Nano. If all hardwares are from Siemens side, then I would recommend to go with MindConnect Nano and MindConnect 2040 instead of Semetic also. Because in Semetic, as I shown on this web page, you need to do programming also. So there is no straight away some connector that can directly push Semetic 2040 data with MindSphere. So you have to write some code, whatever I have shown it here. So how data flow should be there, what all the elements we need to get it or variables we need to get it from PLC, how we can map it to the MindSphere. So all this programming we have to do in the Semetic 2040. So there is no standard things are available that you have to keep in mind. But that standard connectivity is directly available in the MindConnect Nano and MindConnect 2040. So their headache and configuration is also quite simple. Okay, any doubt in the connectivity point of view, Semetic 20 or 1500 PLC or Windows Node-RED? You can unmute and ask me
Hello.
Question also in between. Yeah.
Hello.
Hello.
Sir, actually, yes, sir. Sir, actually, I'm using 200 PLC. With Node-RED configuration. So, sir, after IoT 2040 hardware configuration. So whenever I am going to installing the Node-RED ID, registration.
No, in between I lost you. Can you repeat once again? After onboarding, what you said?
Yes, sir. Sir, actually, whenever I am going to install the Node-RED, sir, in that moment I am facing an issue. Actually, the issue is. Registry issue, sir.
But you are installing Node-RED in the Windows or Semetic 2040?
Semetic 2040.
In Semetic 2040, you don't have to install Node-RED. It is already installed in that OS, which is available on support site. You have to just start that Node-RED service by putting command start Node-RED. You don't have to do any installation in the Semetic 2040. What installation is required? Once the Node-RED server has been installed, you have to install specific libraries from this Node-RED server, which is on the cloud. From that, you install this library. For example, communication with S7, you have to install S7 library. For communication with MindSphere, you have to install MindConnect library, not Node-RED server. So have you tried to install this library?
Yes, sir. I have also installed the library, but sir, actually I am using the PuTTY configuration.
Yeah, I know.
Yes, sir. For but sir, the request error.
Okay. If you have specific issue related to that something installation, I'll share my mail ID, or maybe with Govind we can talk it maybe after this session. Okay.
Yes, sir.
If you are getting some specific error. Apart from that. Anybody having some doubt on this connectivity point of view? So as I said, without hardware also, you can establish communication between your devices with MindSphere via this Windows Node-RED also.
Hello.
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 Yeah.
Yes, this is Nilesh here.
Right.
Actually, as we know that we can connect 1500 with that pro, I mean 1500 library that
MindConnect lib, AB block.
Yeah, with that MindConnect lib, that is different, and this Node-RED one is different, right?
Yes, that is basically it is a TI portal based library.
You have to import that library into TI and then you can connect with that.
Right, right.
And this is with Node-RED.
Yeah, this is a open source software is there, that Node-RED. You can install in your Windows system.
Yes,
and through that also you can connect your existing hardware, not only 1500 PLC, 1200, even third-party devices with MindSphere. Because in this Node-RED, you can see different type of options are also there. Say, for example, OPC is there, Modbus TCP is there, libraries are there. So through that you can get the data from different third party devices also. Okay. This connectivity point, if it is clear for you, I'll just share this link also. That is there, how to connect 1500 PLC directly with MindSphere, either via MQQT communication protocol or via directly the library which is available into the TI portal. So both way are possible. So even 1200 is also possible to connect with MindSphere, but that is via MQQT communication protocol. That is our MindConnect IoT extension. That is a little bit different way to communicate this 1200 with MindSphere. Okay, now I'll move to the PPT. So that was about the connectivity element. So that connectivity element, whatever I've shown, that comes under MindConnect API or Leap. Okay, and then for the MQQT, if you are going with MQQT communication, then you have to use MindConnect IoT extension, which is there on our in the MindSphere portal with the help of this MindConnect IoT extension. So you can establish other MQQT client devices with the MindSphere over MQQT communication protocol. And the other elements which is already there, but for that you need little bit higher level languages. For example, with the help of software agent like Java or C++, even you can establish communication of your existing hardware with the MindSphere. Okay, that is about the connectivity point of view. Now I'll go into the application. So on the MindSphere side, we have two options. So either first option, like already some standard application already there, that is a general purpose application. Some of the application it is in point of view OEM, some of the application in point of view of end user. So that straight away you can use it in the your MindSphere portal. That you have to purchase, like MindSphere having a app portal, from that you can purchase it and use in your application. And second option, already if customer is not, I mean to say he has some customized requirement which is not fulfilling with the help of this application, you can create your own application with the help of developer account, and that you can sell to the customer, then he can use it. So today I'll focus on the first option, which is already some applications are there. And as you can see on this slide, there are five applications that are available from semantic FA point of view. This is a application, it is there. First one is a machine monitor, second it is a notifier, performance insight, machine insight, energy manager. So the machine monitor basically application, it is in terms of for the say customer who is like using machine like packaging industry or maybe a paper or sort of PMA application, that I would say. That application machine monitor is useful for that type of OEMs with coming under PMA application. And then notifier, that is application nothing but it is giving a notification, push notification on your mobile or web-based application, says some important things. Maybe you can say consider some threshold values reaching, or some maintenance activity should be there, or even it is also giving a notification to for supply chain management point of view also. Some raw material is now going to finish, or it is not available, or depending on your scheduler, you have to order new raw material, something like this. That type of notification can be also get it. Second one is a performance insight. This is a general purpose application for the OEM basically, or even you can consider for end user point of view also. Basically, this application will give you completely transparency, plant transparency or machine or production transparency by monitoring different type of KPIs of the machine line or plant, which is related to your productivity. So for example, availability of machine, UE of the machine, or maybe a performance rate or quality rate of the your particular machine or line or maybe plant. Even you can compare different machine performance also. Then third application, that is a machine insight, which is not available now, but it is going to come. Basically, with the help of this Machine Insight app, you will get complete diagnostic of your hardware. So diagnostic in terms of whatever diagnostic of 1500 PLC, straight away it will be available on the cloud, on the MindSphere side with the help of this application. Diagnostic information of Cinemix, all the drives, IOs, everything will be available. that is giving completely diagnostic information of the machines. And the last application, that is a semantic energy manager. So if you already knowing that, we have also application that is on premises, that is our energy manager pro. Same type of functionality is also available, so you'll get completely energy transparency of your plant machine with the help of this energy manager application. There are different type of dashboards, different type of ways are there how we can see transparency of your plant, energy transparency of plant or machine on this application. So even it will show is there any wastage of energy during productive time, or maybe during lunch break, even your machine is off, but still it is consume some energy because electric components are used in that particular machine or controller, then still it will consume some energy. And then how much energy is consumed? Or even you can see at end user side, having two line one and line two, both are having same type of production, but line one is consuming more energy than line two. Then why that line one is consuming more energy? What all the different devices, those are consuming more energy? So once you understood with the help of this application, then you can implement different type of options. For example, you can do the load management with the help of our energy suit application. Even you can do the condition monitoring of particular motor or maybe fan to make preventive maintenance. These things can be possible once you get the energy transparency. So I'll go one by one. So this is the first application, Performance Insight. So as I said, this is a standard application straight away available. You have to just get it, activate it, and it's definitely having a cost depending on KPIs, how many KPI you are going to use it. Depending on that, the charge will get to you. Cost and other factor today, I'll not talk to you. If you have any doubt on that cost factor, or if you have any question, maybe my colleague Govind and will answer you later on, or even Sandeep sir also. So basically, as I said, this Performance Insight application will give a benefit such that you can calculate your all KPIs of your machines. To calculate the KPIs in this application, it is a completely flexible. You can put your own formulas to calculate KPIs. So that flexibility is available. You can configure your KPIs for the machine or plant. And due to it is on the cloud base, it can be accessed worldwide, anywhere, anyone who has access of this application, and they can analyze the machine data. And once the data is available, basically you can then take decision depending on this KPIs. So for example, if you today you can see today your machine is manufacturing 100 pieces per minute, and once you understood after manufacturing 100 pieces per minute during 8 hours, your machine is idle maybe for 2 hours, because then there is no job for that machine. Then maybe you can increase your productivity by planning more production. Say, for example, instead of 100, you can say plan for 120, something like this. So that decision making can be straight away possible once you visualize this data under this application. And to visualize this data, analytical data, we have different type of widgets are there. So in terms of chart, you can see the performance of your machine. With the help of Gauges, you can see different type of options. Say, for example, quality rate. If quality rate, if you are defining good product divided by total product, then straight away with the help of this Gauge, you will come to know that how many good products has been manufactured by that particular machine or line, and how many bad product has been manufactured. Straight away, you can see complete transparency on quality rate also. Similar as same, you can select the time period also. So today, for example, you are looking for the shift performance, but maybe after implementation of this application, if you want to see maybe last month performance of machine or plant. So with the help of this flexible time period option, even you can select different time slot to visualize your machine performance. So this is about this Performance Insight. Moving towards in detail, basically, as I said, take an example of machine. And as I said, in the machine, through this dashboard itself, you will come to know that what is your machine information, what is your quality rate. So in detail, you can visualize all these things. So this can be visualized in different way. even you can visualize heat map of your machine also. So heat map is nothing but during particular shift or during particular defined period, machine is operating in in working mode for maybe a 7 hours, but 1 hour is not working in the operation, maybe due to maintenance or some activity. Then through heat map, you will come to know that that particular month machine was operating maybe a maximum in the working mode or maximum into the aborted mode. So such a heat map can be directly seen on the application. And apart from that, as I said, it is also supporting GAN control. So in the GAN control, you'll come to know that say machine is working in the specific shift, and this specific shift machine, how many times machine was there in the aborted mode. So straight away you can see that time particular, say maybe morning 8 to 9 machine was in the aborted mode. Then you can even, if you are developing logic, you will come to know that why that abortion was happened. So why maybe operator was not there, or maybe raw material was not there, or maybe there is a electric problem, or maybe there is a tool change over time was there. So some different things will be there. So definitely you will come to know that what is my downtime of the machine. So you will get complete detail analysis of your downtime also. So downtime will cover defined downtime and some of the unwanted or maybe undefined downtime. So everything can be visualized. And through that, definitely will reduce then your downtime of your machine also. So this can be visualized on this application. And if you go in detail, even you can do the some out of the box analytics also. So you can put some anomalies correlation also. So you can put some, say this is my reference value, and on that reference value of particular production, so what is your current production value of your machine or plant? It's really in between your reference, or it is a far behind that your reference target or something like this can be done. Even you can do the statistics also. So in the statistics, you will come to know that mean value of max value or average value, standard deviation of your production. So everything can be visualized here. And this can be also display on the shop floor also, because in the shop floor also, it they required some sort of hand-on things. They should always know their target count and how much it has been manufactured. So sort of things per hour, per minute can be also visualized on the shop floor also. So by putting this dashboard on some big display. As I said, the application is nice. It is giving so many truthful information. For example, KPIs of the machines or plant, OE, quality rate, performance monitor, or availability of the machines. But to get all this data, definitely we need required a gateways. And as I said, these are the different gateway can talk to on different machines also. So this could be a the scenario, for example, at end user side. So at end user side, during particular line having a different type of machine, Siemens combination, Mitsubishi. So these gateways are providing different type of options for the communication: S7, Ethernet IP, Modbus TCP, RTU, PCUA. Through that, we can directly get the data from this machine, and we can directly connect to this application purpose insight. So that FBA application is available under the support site, and these are the some order numbers are there for this hardware. So this is a first scenario. Consider this application already was sold to the say, for example, maybe a OEM. So then if you are selling his machine, or maybe end user, so we can implement this purpose inside application, maybe a site A and site B. So then with the help of this cloud-based technology, as I said, worldwide, you can access it. So simply in his corporate office, he can visualize the performance of site A compared with performance B. So who is performing more? So that can be visualized under this application. So that is about Purpose Insight. Do you have any doubt in this application? Okay, one more thing. Let's say if you are unable to raise your doubt also, maybe you are unmuting this application, it is also possible to put your question into the chat window. Okay, as already going something. So you can write your doubt in this chat window. So one session is over, I'll take one by one also.
So that is also possible. Now, next application, that is a schematic energy manager. And this is a very important nowadays. These things are required in the plant or machine point of view, because government having some stringent law about this energy consumption, all that. So basically, this application will give a completely transparency of energy consumption in the machine or plant or line. And main thing is that this application support ISO. So that standard is also supporting, and same as which is already there, look and feel point of view, it is a similar performance inside. Even it is also possible to configure your own KPI of energy in flexible manner. So you can define your own formulas to calculate energy KPIs. That is also possible to get energy efficiency measures. And with the help of this application, even it is also possible to put some cost per machine, how much energy has been consumed. So energy cost, energy consumption, CO2 emission can be directly shown on this application. So that is a completely available. And same like Performance Insight, it also supports some gadgets like chart, pie, gauge, or Senki. That is very important. I'll talk on, and heat map. So this is a possible. But before going to this energy manager, I just want to show the demo for this Performance Insight application. When you log into your tenant of MindSphere, this is your home page. You landed to this home page, and what all the applications you are purchasing, that will be available for this your tenant. So for example, in this tenant, you can see Fleet Manager is already there. That is a free of cost application, then which will visualize your data in trend format. Second, Energy Manager application. Now I'm going to talk on that. Then Performance Insight was already now part of my this tenant. Notifier application is already there. Then Machine Monitor, that is also there. And then another application which I have purchased, that Visual Pro Creator. So if you are not, say, customer is not happy with this application, or it is not fulfilling their requirement, then with the help of Visual Flow Creator also, you can create your own application. So that is also there. The Visual Flow Creator is somewhat like Node-RED development only. Once the data is available into your asset manager, into the database, then simply with the help of Fleet Manager, we can visualize your variable data in different format. So for example, consider F&B example. So how much rice has been consumed, corn, peanut. So that data can be visualized under this application. You can segregate also, you can create different variable trends also. Through this also, you can create some notification also. Now talking about the Performance Insight application. So in this Performance Insight application, basically, when you land to the asset manager, then in the Performance Insight, I think still my net issue is there, I'm working from home. So you can create your plant hierarchy also. So for example, in my plant, specific name is there, a plant, you can create a hierarchy. In the plant, you have 10 lines. And that 10 line also, you have each line having a specific four type of or five type of machines are there. Some filling, if it is a packaging machine, then cartoning, labeling, so many machines are there. So you can drill down up to that particular machine level, and then you can visualize your machine KPIs also. So this can be visualized in terms of value, or maybe a donut, or some different type of gauges. And as I said, it also possible to visualize your machine status also. So machine was working maybe or available maybe for 5 hours or 12 hours or within 3 days, 12 hours was available. But after that, machine was not available maybe for independent time. Again, it was available. It was in the power up mode. So with the help of this Gantt view also, you will come to know. So that is about this Performance Insight. And in configuration window, you can configure your own KPIs. So that KPI configuration is also directly with the help of this configuration window. So user can create their own KPIs. And basically, this license is always check how many KPIs you have used in your project. So say for example, if you are using 3 KPIs, availability, quality rate, and say performance rate, these 3 KPIs. But this KPIs you are using maybe for 10 times. So 10 times is nothing but for line 1, line 2, line 3, line 10. So if you are using these 10 instances for 10 line, then you have to pay for that 10 KPIs. Okay. So this is how the concept it is there. So that is about the performance insight, how it looks like and KPI compression, quite simple. Now coming towards the next energy point of view. So this is a automation pyramid. We have also energy pyramid is there. So to visualize your energy data, definitely we need a gateways which can get it data from your existing machines or plant or line. And then with the help of this application, we can visualize data. But to get the energy data, definitely we require energy meters. Without this energy meter, it is not possible to visualize energy data. So in this acquisition level, we have different type of energy meters are available. Already, if you know our internet SP, say for example, OEM is manufacturing machine, and in the machine he want to just give some USP to his end user that his machine is giving energy transfers, how much energy is consuming per production. If he just want to give this status to the customer, and he is not going to use any energy meter because already in his machine HMI and PLC is there. So in our 1200 or 800 SP family, we have energy meters. So through that, we can directly fetch the data from the energy with the help of CTPT, and that can be directly passed to the controller. So with the help of energy suite application or e-monitor, that is a local energy application, we can visualize energy consumption data on the HMI and same PLC data, then either with the help of gateway or this PLC itself, we can transfer this truthful information related to energy consumption on the MindSphere side on this energy app. Application. So that pyramid you have to fulfill it. So so we have a chance to sell our energy meters also. So energy can be get it via meters, pack meters or conserve meters on different communication protocol, or maybe on the SIMO code side, or maybe on the drives, this energy data can be get it. And once the data is available on this MindSphere site, on the MindSphere database, so with the help of this application, we can create different type of gadgets. So for example, this is with the help of SendKey, you will come to know that energy consumption. I'll directly show on the application itself. So that is a energy application. Say, if I go to the energy application, again in this application, I can create a same hierarchy. So plant A, and under that plant A, I have 10 lines. Under that 10 line also, I have different type of machines are there. So under production line, I have this 1, 2, 3, 4 standard machines, and there is one utilities also. So for that particular plant, what is my net energy supply that I can straight away shown it here. And some of the energy supply we are getting from maybe a local electricity provider, maybe a state board or maybe other player. Or it is also possible to have energy from our solar energy also. Maybe somebody has visited our Kalwa factory there, we are also using solar power to provide the energy to the factories. So how much my net supply is there? Once the net supply is available, how much my factory is consuming? So the factory will having a net supply from electric source provider and also from maybe solar. And out of that, factory is dividing in two way. One will supply is required for the production, and second is required for the offices. So for offices, how much my energy is consuming, and for the production, how much energy is consuming. So in the production, for filler, how much energy is required, for mixer, how much energy is required. So you will come to know in detail that SendKey view up to that machine level, how much energy has been consumed. Same way, this energy law is there. Say for example, the energy source, they normally ask for the consumer how much load is required for you, how much particular power consumption is required for maybe of 1 year for you, just let us know. Once you tell them that particular figure, then they will sanction that particular load, energy load, and that will be available throughout the year for us. But during that particular sanction load, in the peak time, let's say you have sanctioned maybe 11 kilowatt, and during peak time you are exceeding that maybe a load. So for example, you are exceeding only 1 kilowatt extra. So whatever charges you are getting for the 11 kilo sanction load, then due to that peak, they will not charge only for 11 kilo. They will charge you completely for year for that 11 kilo, not for your 10 kilo sanction. So to avoid these things, so with the help of heat map, you will come to know that my machine, a particular machine, is consuming how much energy during which time. So that can be straight away visualized, which will be in the red indication. And if it is unwanted load, straight away with the help of load management application in the TI portal, you can say shut down all the unwanted load which is not required during the peak time in the factory. So that can be visualized under this heat map, and that is very important things. One more thing, it will also show the electricity consumption per unit. But it is not only showing electricity, even under the electric, you'll get non-electrical energy also. So electrical energy is one thing, but apart from that, you can visualize also non-electrical energy like gas consumption, compressed air consumption of that specific machine. So all this detail can be visualized under this application. And you can see complete quantity and of production. And for that particular production quantity, how much my energy consumption is there. So you can even visualize in terms of cost also. So for example, this is another dashboard is there. So in this dashboard, now I have seen in complete overview of the production line. And under that, I am going to the specific packaging line or packaging machine. So in this packaging machine, so per day, how much energy has been consumed? So say, for example, per shift, this particular machine is working in different mode. So if you are using OMAX standard, then machine will work in the different mode. For example, operational mode, working mode, standby mode, maybe a maintenance mode. So there are different type of modes are there in the machine. So in this mode, how much energy is consumed? So with the help of this consumption data, you will come to know that most of the now in the green means that machine was in the working mode, and whatever energy is consumed, definitely it has been required for the production. So depending on that also, you are getting some production. But there are red indication also there. So the red indication is nothing but this energy may be a wastage. Why wastage? Because during, say, lunch break, that time your production was not there, but your machine was switched on. So normally nobody switch off the their electronical component. Even there is a production or not there, doesn't matter. They normally keep it all these things. So then you will come to know that during that period, even there is some energy consumption is there. So that wastage, once you understood from this graph, so you can implement some things in the your machine or line that during particular time, you can put all the devices into the energy saving mode. So it will consume very less energy even in idle condition also. So that can be visualized under this graph, and you will come to know that how much my valuable energy is there. So this can be visualized under this application. So that's about the demo. And to configure all these things is completely flexible. You can configure the your different KPIs of the energy. KPIs, which we can configure under this performance insight or performance monitor application. So that is a very well possible. So I'll come to the again slide. So as I said, performance insight, we can also do some analytics, statistics, mean consumption, maximum consumption, standard deviation, everything can be visualized under this application. So which I already shared. So red indication means consumption in idle mode, that is energy wastage, and green is always your consumption during the working mode. So what is my degree of efficiency? So what is my saving potential? So this red, definitely there I can look after, that can maximum say 10 to 20% definitely I can save once this transfer is there in the application. So I can see detailed transfer in also for specific energy source also. So how much water is consuming, gas is consuming, electricity. So detailed energy along with the cost, we can visualize under this application. So the same scenario, site A, site B, if you pushing this application, then we can compare site energy consumption with site B, then which site is consuming more energy. That can be visualized under this application. So that's it from my side regarding energy application. And as I said, in the KPI, you can create your own KPIs. So you can provide your own formulas, say name, maybe for example, KW or something. Unit, say maybe for example, this is a energy something. Maybe for the machine something, I'll just mention. And then unit will be a KWH. So this simple configuration is there. Then I can define my own formulas here. So variable will be available, you just define this KPI. Once you define the KPI like energy meal, quality rate or valuable energy, then you can simply connect this KPI to your energy medium. So then you can show all this your energy medium in terms of different colors. And then you can map it your status. So for machine VDMA, so I can simply connect my different tags to here. So working condition, which tag and for how many times it should be there. So can be done it. So configuration point of view also it is quite simple. And visualize also, as you've seen, we are getting truthful dashboards also. Okay, any doubt in this energy application? If not, then I will move to the next application, which is there. That is a semantic notifier. As I said, this semantic notifier will also be helpful in terms of reduce downtime or increase the production. It's having two versions basically. The first version, now I can say with the help of semantic edge, is also having three versions. The first version, that is a local base. So semantic notifier you can install on the local PC or maybe on the central room. That is the software is available. And in this software, it is also possible to push your notification on your mobile by connecting different vendor PLC also. Maybe over S7 communication, OPCUA communication. You can straight away get data from the from PLC into the central room. And with the help of the software, it will give notification to the respective engineer or maybe manager. So maybe, for example, maintenance engineer or maybe line supervisor, something is exceeding. So that is the first version, that is locally. So within low plant itself, you will get this notification. And if you are interested to do this on the cloud side, then through cloud also, through internet, it doesn't matter if you are in the same plant or if you are outside the plant, you will get this notification on your browser or mobile devices. So with the help of this MindSphere, this is also possible. So but this is independent on the browser. So any browser, you can use it. The more native app was not there, but now they have also released a mobile semantic notifier app also, that is on the iOS. So with the help of this application like WhatsApp, you'll get this notification on this application also. So that is there. And the scenario is like that. For example, first scenario we can consider, there is a material shortage. So you can define this particular notification. So there you can create it. Particular material shortage, definitely on the mobile you will get this notification. Second scenario, there is a some the particular machine. So normally what happened then, normally end user operator will call to the maybe maintenance engineer. If he is able to provide solution, he will definitely provide. If he is not capable to provide the solution, he will call to the OEM. Okay, and then OEM will take the action. But definitely in between that time will go, and then there is a much more downtime, and then there is a production loss, and definitely there is a hit for the cost in terms of production for the end user, and definitely then he will charge to him also depending on their contract. So to avoid all these things, so machine will directly give notification directly to the OEM also. So you don't have to wait for the call from maintenance engineer or end user or other people. So this type of notification can be also get it, and you can immediately take the action on that. So it's having three types of notification: alert, warning, and information. So alert is basically critical information, that is always in the red indication. And in this notification, even it is also possible, once you take some action, then only you can accept this notification or you can acknowledge it. And then it will give some audit things that that was the node, a particular ID of that notification, the when somebody has accepted this notification, and then what was the time and which machine was there. So that particular log will be also available. So maybe in past also, if you want to see what all the things or how much service I utilize for that particular machine or for that customer, from that you will come to know this thing. So as I said, this notification can be visualized under this mobile application also. So that type of warning, it is our information or a critical alarm, say. So that can get it. On the put it with MindSphere application, but smartwatch with local notifier. That is, I'm talking on premises. So with on premises also, you will get the notification on smartwatch. That's notifier application is also available. Through that, you will get this notification. So that is about semantic notifier application. I'll now I'll just show you the demo of this notifier. So I'll just log in to this thing. Once you log into this application, then with the help of the setting, you can create your own notification. So you can create, so you can filter it. Only you want to see alert, only you want to see this notification, or it is also possible to create your own notification. So you can create filter and add this notification particular and this compare greater than equal to, it is a alert or warning. That tag you can assign it and connect it here. Then the user information to whom that notification should get it. So that particular ID that you have to define it. Then this notification will be available. And in the archive section, if you are already accepting some notification or if you are already acknowledging, then all history will be available. So straight away you can see your own filter, my own notification, or if you just click on the all, then your complete notification of that particular machine with respect to all users will be visualized under this archive. And in notification section, you will see the current notification along with the timestamp and name of that machine. Notification is coming, and then you can define which notification is required. So this sort of things can be directly shown on this notification. So that is about the notifier. So this notifier, even you can club with performance insight or manager if some threshold is exceeded, which is important in terms of say for example quality rate. So you can club this notifier with performance insight. So you can link this performance insight data with this notifier, and that notification can be use it. Then next application, that is a semantic machine monitor. Basically this application, as I said, more useful in terms of machine service, in terms of for PMA application. So in this notification application, again you will get the important things like KPI, like productivity or of the machines. Apart from that, even you can put some maintenance indicator also. So maintenance activity also can be visualized under this application. And likewise, OMAC standard, which is there in the PacML industry, that PacML standard, that type of state model also we can visualize under this machine monitor application. So straight away you can see productivity of your machine. So alarm indication and also some maintenance activity. So you can define that, say for example, the OEM is having machine which having some pneumatic actuator is there, and that pneumatic actuator is having some definite life, maybe a 100,000 stroke. That actuator life is there, and after 100 stroke you have to change, you have to do the service for that actuator if that is application. So with the help of this machine monitor, you can define that maintenance activity of that actuator. It will check the continuous count of that particular actuator stroke, and once it reaches to the say maybe 1,000, maybe if you are defining after 900 you should get the alarm that now you have to look after the service. Then after 900 you will get immediately this notification that you have to do the servicing for that actuator. And after 1,000, definitely will say that now it is overdue. So you are not doing servicing, and definitely the system is going to the time. So just do the servicing. So that type of maintenance activity can be also visualized under this machine monitor application. So I'll just show you the demo of this machine application. I'll just log in. So basically this is a look and feel of this machine. Again, the hierarchy point of view also you can see all type of your line and machines. So under that you will see the KPIs of your machine also. So availability of your machine, performance, quality rate, and during hours, even with the help of this trend also you can, you will come to know this thing. So this is also possible. I think if I log into this, then maintenance activity, for example, this Bonjon machine, what I was telling about this. So you can see the complete your calendar. So when you want to do the some activity, so for example, the distance control, disassembly, so travel distance, so you will get the alarm. So during this yellow zone, you are giving that alert. You have to do certain activity, and after that red indication, it will show already due date is over, and you have to take the corrective action. Otherwise, things will go in some fault condition. And in history, we will see who has done which maintenance activity and what was that activity. So everything history can be visualized under this. That is under maintenance, and under productivity, you can see complete say productive data of your machines. Say maybe for example. I can see the one status also. So machine was working in the specific OMAC standard 17 state. In this 17 state, maybe in Wednesday, maybe in first shift today, maybe a Thursday today in first shift, machine was working in which state and how many time it was there in step, or machine was always going into the aborted mode. Why this is always going to the aborted mode? So that particular status or particular state of the model of the machine can be directly visualized under this application. So that is about the machine monitor. Now I'll move to the machine insight. So I hope this is clear. Now this is also the new application which is coming. This is not directly available now, but with the help of this machine insight application also, whatever data we are getting on the local platform, maybe on HMI or SCADA or maybe a PLC or diagnostic paper, same type of diagnostic data or service information data will be available on this machine insight application. So basically it will straight away read the semantic PLC diagnostic buffer or cinemic buffers or some additional service data on the cloud. And through that, you'll come to know that machine health or plant health. So you can do the asset switching for that. You can do the asset monitoring and all this stuff. So that can be also get it via this machine insight. So these are the different type of applications are available. As I said, these are the five applications. Out of the current running applications are there, performance insight, that you will get the complete transparency of your plant. Second application, notifier, that is a push notification in terms of a different type of notification, maintenance activity or service activity or maybe production related notification. And then third is a machine monitor, that is for the maintenance and machine activity related data you will get it. And then last one is a energy manager. Here you will get the complete transparency of energy for the plant or machine or maybe a line. That's it from my side regarding the application. The new the one thing I just
sorry I'm interrupting you. Can you go back on the slide where you shown the state of the machine and all the things in the graphical manner?
This
I have a question on that. Back one slide back.
Which application you mean to say?
Say machine monitor only.
No, that I think I have shown on the actual demo only. This is the actual demo on the
Mindsphere. Okay, so you have shown on the, this one. So in this, is it possible to see the reasons for example, suspended or stopping in the red zone which you have shown? Like you mentioned, you can also see.
You can do the reasoning also. It is also possible to do it, but this cannot be directly with this application. You have to link up with maybe with a notifier or something like this, combined with notifier. And
so we cannot see in the same page. That means
same
page. Two different pages. It will be same page.
Same different pages. History of complete statuses. Then they are also possible to have say time slot. So particular machine, you can consider this is a time slot. Maybe for machine A, and then you can see all these things.
Okay.
This is nothing but you can straight away integrate your OMAC standard into this MindSphere. It is also possible to providing this thing. I think I don't have write up this application here, so I'm not able to show it because it's just read only. But you can implement or you can configure your OMAC standards straight away as it is into the MindSphere side.
Okay.
I will not work on this specific application. Our PMA team is working on that. But still, I'll note down this question and I'll come back to you.
Sure. Thank you.
Okay, last slide. This is, I don't know, Sandeep sir. Sandeep sir, are you there?
Yeah,
I'm there. I'll talk on this trial period. So are you going to cover these things or? Okay. So.
Go ahead.
Okay, so basically whatever application we have seen, to give just a glimpse or to just show a few things to the customer definitely is not going to buy immediately. First, he will say, I need a POC or I just want to see things maybe a few days and then I'll go for this application. So we are also providing this 3 month free trial period for all this application. And once he will configure, or once we activate this free trial period, 3 months. So in this 3 month trial period, what all the things he will get it, depending on his requirement, he can select which application you want to go ahead with. Only Purpose Insight, Notifier, or combination of all this, or maybe all. Along with this application, definitely to visualize this application, we require a MindSphere platform value also. Plan. So, value plan also. Right. So along with this application, we are also getting a MindSphere IoT value plan as a small package. Okay, small IoT value plan. That is also getting it. So whatever specification are given for that small value plan, it will be applicable for this all application also. And only thing is that additionally he has to purchase, so that gateway he has to purchase it. But for 3 months, once he purchases the gateway, then he can visualize all these machine or plant or line data with the help of this application. And after 3 months, say for example, if he's really liking this application, then he can continue and then place the order on the to get this PO. So this is a possibility is there. So that is very good in terms of just push the standard application along with this value plan, because it's very important. So we are also getting this value plan as a free trial along with this application. And then depend, let's say if he is not interested, maybe even by putting this or by sending mail to the support site, he can continue with this application.
Got it. So Dhananjay, what you said, I just want to repeat, because yes, in our scheme, most of the system integrator have procured only the developer tenant. Now, if they want to utilize this free semantic applications, that is application of suits, I nominate that as a application suit, because there are a lot of applications bundled together. So the offering and bundling for the scheme, which I think we have rolled out, is clubbed with a IoT value plan. Okay. So if suppose they have to go for this package, 3 months free package for semantic application, they get semantic value plan also free for 3 months. So effectively, when they place an order, for example, I treat this as one order. If they place an order, effectively 3 months application is free, 3 months even the value plan also is free. But for next 12 months, the value plan as well as application will be charged to them. So this is how the scheme is defined as of now. So if anyone is interested in the scheme, you do revert to me and Govind. We can get back to you in due course of time. Yeah. And as Dhananjay requested, all hardware, whichever is required to collect the data from machine or from plant, is to be procured and supplied separately or extra, depending on site situation. Hello.
That's it from my side. I can say end of the presentation demonstration.